Hi, I'm Subhash from Smaran NGO. There's some PPT. Before that, I'll just share some information. I just want to know how many are from this local region, Hyderabad and surroundings. Good, okay. Because my most of the works are, in Hyderabad and surroundings. So it is, limited to this area, but it suits to the Deccan Plateau wherever, like Bangalore, as Madam was showing that. So those are the places which are suitable. And I'll just a small question for the people who are this region particularly. Do you know what was the groundwater level 30 years back, roughly, approximately? How our fathers, our parents, used to dig boreholes for how many feet? 30, 35 years back. Okay. And then that should be open wells. I'm telling the borewells. It was just 80 feet. Maximum they used to go for 120 feet, that's all. So entire Hyderabad and the villages also, just 80 feet, 90 feet, 100 feet borehole. That was the depth. And now imagine, can you just say what is the depth? Now present the depth. Yeah. It is 15, 2 and 2 above, 2 plus, 2000 feet plus. And which is giving yield right now, it's a question mark. Till how many months and till how many, 1 year or 2 years? No one can say. It may drop giving yield within a month also. That is the present status. And every apartment has at least 3-4 average boreholes now. One is not working, yeah, that's right. One is not working, they quickly go, in a night they will decide, and next day they will go for a deeper borehole. They leave that abandoned, which gave you water earlier, they leave it. It is some investment you have done. You have taken money for so many, taken water for so many years, it is abandoned, and they go for. That's one alternate, and second is they depend on the tankers. The tankers, huge tankers. You can see the tankers are now equaling to the number of autos and buses this year particularly. They are also coming, every one vehicle will see a tanker also behind us. And they are all done by, some unprofessional drivers. And the tankers are also not in a good shape. All second and third scrap vehicles, they are used for carrying the water. And that water also, as Madam was telling, that water is taken from the boreholes dug near the water bodies. Those water bodies, all water bodies in Hyderabad and surroundings are sewage entry points. And the garbage is dumped, is burnt 24 hours. That water seeps into the water body and that is being carried. And the people wait for the tanker. And they pay, they are ready to pay. They hold their purses and, they want to pay as soon as the tanker comes. That's the situation now in Hyderabad. And every apartment, or the small or big, are paying not less than, 2 lakhs per annum to 1 crore per annum on water tankers. And can you roughly say this is the area, rooftop, what amount of rainwater will fall in a year? Approximately this much rooftop. If you have this much our house rooftop area, per annum, 30,000. For lakes you are giving a lot of water, but for a house you are reducing the. okay. 8,000 cubic. Approximately for 100 square meters, 70,000 liters plus or minus we receive. So little less than a lakh we will receive this much rooftop area. So we have in Hyderabad now huge rooftop and gated communities are coming up. Rooftop around 1,000 square meters, 2,000 square meters also are available now. Even 2-3 helicopters can land directly at a time. That much rooftop. So 99% water is coming down through the outlets. Where it is going? Any builder, any architect, any famous, reputed engineers or architects, I have seen more than 99% they are not respecting the rainwater. Finally, it is given to the sewage outlets or onto the roads. It is directly given to the sewage drains or onto the roads, which goes onto the roads, damages the roads, overflows the manholes, accidents occur. 7 centimeters rainfall Hyderabad now cannot take. Now Chennai, you have seen more than 30 centimeters in a day. In Hyderabad, 7 centimeters is the limit I have seen so far, where you will find 4 feet water takes 3 hours to recede. That's the situation now, and every day the concrete is increasing. Buildings are going vertically, and it will not take 6 centimeters in future. It will not take 5 centimeters in future also. If you imagine 10 centimeters, I can't imagine really. So that's the situation going on, and even the people, they are looking for well-reputed apartments. Were sometimes people. One ad came recently, helicopter landing provision also is there on the apartments. Luckily, that has not gone through. Due to some legal cases, it has stopped. Everything is there. Marble from Germany they are getting, and see that it is laid. But gravity free water which is falling on our head, going through our feet onto the roads, simple methods we are not adopting. And there are thousands of boreholes, I will not say lakhs, thousands of boreholes lying abandoned. Like 30 years back, 120 feet, then further 20 years back, 400 feet, 10 years back, 1,000 feet. There are ready assets available hidden in our apartments. We can utilize them. Now, the recent Water Works Department came with an act policy. They want to go for a new borehole and allow the rainwater to go there. When thousands, lakhs of boreholes are already available, and they cannot go for a new borehole because they can't enter the vehicle also. It's already built. Already the walls are there. You cannot demolish and go for a new borehole. Burn the diesel, spend money, our money. Why they should think like that? And one other officer says, we will go for a Bangalore model. Already city is built. 90% is built. For new houses, he says, we'll apply a Bangalore model. When you have infrastructure, when you have possibilities, you do it there. Don't wait for the new people or new who are not yet born. So these are the things, government, one department says like this, the other department says like this, and they have money also collected against RWS component, all in crores. They are not spending also and planning differently. Against want to spend money also. So a small introduction, since 10-12 years we are promoting site-specific suitable RWS structures, rainwater. In generally in our Hyderabad, people think harvesting. They think that we just dig a small pit and throw some stones. Done. At least they will not see, because the DHMC also does like that. At valley, where is the valley? Where is the reach? They don't see. Water from where? Which point going? Common sense. At least their water will fill into the pit and the excess will go out. They do at the reach points. And they only for the count purpose. So many numbers, so many thousands. Next day in paper comes, some 10,000 we have built. So this is the, still even though it is going on. And we also worked with rural areas 12 to 13 years back. But now mostly in urban areas we are giving our time. This one model we have given to GHMC in 2013. It's a 10 acres plot. In Balkampet, Nature Cure Hospital, they have 10 acres and their main requirement is water and black silt, black soil for the patients. That's the medicine, that's the kind of treatment they are doing. And they buy 6 tankers per day. Having in spite of 10 acres and huge open land area, these 2 acres I have selected, and there are 2 boreholes abandoned. There's no water, they left. It's our money, government money. So one bore I have taken, which is abandoned, which they have neglected. And as per gravity, this was, from here the entire water is going onto the roads. We built a small structure where all the leaf fall and silt is arrested. And the rainwater, when it fills up that structure, it is given connection to this borehole. This is around 1,000 feet. It will cost around 1,50,000 or 1,70,000 now at present. So there are 2,70,000 hidden in the ground. So one we have taken. And the entire water, whenever it rains, 2 acres of area, that building rooftop water and the open area, it comes. Luckily, there are no vehicles coming in regularly. So we have taken that, we have selected that area. Entire water is now, it is fed to the, this borehole. We had a good rains in 2013, around 1000 mm. Our average rainfall is 700 to 800 mm, but that year 1000 mm. We are able to capture entire water, and those six tankers for a year, they have not called. And nearby two boreholes got full recharged. This was the, and 8 acres also they are supposed to do, but it is government institute. They will take their own time. If they have done for remaining area also, I think in future they will never call a tanker. They need not look for a tanker at all. Yeah, in 2011 we have done to a NIFT in Madhapur Hitex. They have some 700 girls studying, residents and other 100 staff. Around 900 people are working there. So they have a rooftop, huge rooftop, 3500 square meters. Entire water used to come, you know, at one point. That's the point. There's an architect has given a, you know, some pool-like structure. And there one borehole is there, just 190 feet. So we have flushed it, and we made some structures, you know, all leaf and backfills we have made it. Only rainwater will go into that, and the excess will go to the new borehole, which is 1000 feet. In Madhapur, there is no, they say that it is third layer. It has gone to third layer. So first, second layer, they're not giving water. And they used to buy 15 tankers per day, big tankers, around 14,000 liters each tanker. They used to buy 15 tankers. In 1 year, it has come down to 8 tankers per day. And in the second year, next slide, the second bore, and that's the third building, working bore. These are all working bore wells. Next slide. Previous. And in 2 years, they have completely no tankers coming up. Around 40 lakhs per annum they are saving. That. Next slide. This one more gated community, around 20 acres. Entire water is going out, so we have to channelize again back to their premises. Luckily, they left 1 acre of area where we are able to do that structures. This one interesting thing, you know, this is in Gachibowli nearby. This apartment, as you see that, all the PVC pipes which are rooted on that ceiling side, earlier all on the roads only, all will go to the main roads. And 80% or 90% we are able to route to the new borehole, and the working borehole is nearby only. Entire water now it is going into the ground. They have observed their current power bill is reduced by 5,000. They used to get 30,000. Now they are getting 25,000, 26,000. The same common lighting, same borewell, and lift. Nothing increased, but 5,000 rupees it is per month it is coming down. The reason is that they said the water table has come up. That's why there's a difference of 5,000 rupees. So imagine for a single apartment 5,000 rupees. So many units, some X units. If you imagine for at least 20% of the city, huge our power. And last year our GHMC commissioner said we will reduce our holdings, all city holdings, time from 7 to 10 only. After that, no power is given for the holdings, so that power will be given to the farmers. It was a huge crisis last year. Farmers were not getting. Compared to that, this act will save a lot of power, money to us and power to the government. So they can think about this actually, instead of just thinking about, you know, reducing that holdings. Next. And some other schools we have done. These are normal pits, but we go for main this method only because it suits our Deccan Plateau, Hyderabad region. The pit will, you know, take the water, stops all the silt. Fresh water only will go to the borehole. This is 1300 feet depth. Whenever it rains, small or big, it will take. So once it goes into the borehole, it goes to the deep aquifer. And it has seen around all the structures, there is no excess water going out. Pits will go. Because pit after 6-7 feet, you will find the boulders and the sheet rock at somewhere. and it will not take that much water percolation. But combination of pit and borehole will take maximum water. And that is what Hyderabad, we should give water from where you are taking, not somewhere else, you know, which cannot take, which cannot accommodate. You give it back there itself and it is available for you. That's the principle, that's the method we need to understand.
Next.
Stop. Only water will go down into the pit, it will rise and enter through the slots. So water should go slowly. That's why all these arrangements are there. Next. And thus, this is one of the gated community in 5.5 acres. Now there are hundreds around city coming up. And there are 540 flats are there. Generally, in earlier days, we used to see one village used to have 200, 300 families or 500 families. They will live in 5,000 or 4,000 acres area, that much families. But now, you will find in city, around city, so many families in just 5 acres only, 5 acres. Of course, they need the same quantity of water. And they are not doing at all. Most of them are not doing. They are doing just, you know, namesake, some demo. Some photo like picture, rainwater harvesting for permission sake. And people call us after they have problem, after 5 years, 6 years. But it is very difficult to do and we cannot do to the full potential available the rooftop area. But still out of our experience, we are able to do 50-60% of the available potential. You can find here 2000 square meters of rooftop, each block. There are 5 blocks. So 2000 means 1000 square meters, 7 lakh liters, 14 lakh liters per block it is available. All the rainwater is going along with the untreated sewage to the nearest water body. This is how almost every apartment. And we made one, there is a working borehole. This front building, half of the portion we are able to give back. There is a parking area. So after doing that, we are able to close it. Again, the vehicles can be parked. Only a small entry is given for the cleaning purpose. Next slide. And children's park. Even there was a protest, you know, cricket ground, we cannot leave that small patch. Children's playground, parents are not happy. But we are able to give back 90% of the dug-up area. 10% is only for the entry, opening. And even cellar also we have done that. And again, after that, car parking is restored. This is the last point, exit point of the rainwater in the cricket ground and some other places we have done. Some college. Here it's a Begumpet. It's in the college is at Begumpet. The tankers come from nearby our place, Rajendranagar, Attapur. Tankers come from here. So after this there are some nearby outskirts, villages are there. So they are sending water, they are selling the water, the farmers, because they get immediate money. And that water is, it comes still here. And see, they have done something. They have done 3 structures like this. And no one is doing, most of them are not doing. This water goes to the Musi. Our water goes to the Musi and we get water from the nearby surrounding villages. This is a school just very nearby, 1 kilometer from here. It's a government school. They have a 5 acres campus, 5 acres area. And one bore was abandoned. It was giving water actually. So Delight has sponsored that. Next. Next. So the surface water, 5 acres of surface water is channelized to this borehole. And we make sure that vehicles are not parked in that area at some point. Only the, you know, playing area, only the landscape area, water only will come there. Next. Yeah, next. And this is the other working bore. Next. Where we routed the entire rooftop water, all the school building. 1300 students are there. Teachers have told them, you bring your own water for drinking. Only they will give water for after lunch. For washing hands. Even that is not sufficient. And that is with almost all the schools. and this is a rooftop area given to the working borehole. So whenever rain comes, it will enter into this, and the life is increased. Life and the yield will keep on increasing. It's similar structure in a centralized hospital. Here, last year we have done. It's also nearby only school. We have a 2,000 bags, 2,000 square meters of meeting hall, and half portion we have taken, and that portico. Together, it is gravity is available, bore is there, and we are able to channelize. Now there are five, six bore wells. Only this bore well and next, and this two are working. Remaining not giving yield. Because they received rains during the season. And here this is Dr. Marichana Reddy Institute, 33 acres. They have called for our report. We have given a report. It's still lying there. See, these are the boreholes. From here, huge rainwater goes out. It is like, you know, Tirupati. It's like on a small hillock. All the rainwater immediately goes to the neighboring places. And this one more borehole, you have a huge rooftop area where we can do possibilities. And one more borehole, there are quarters are there. Next, it's a nursery. There is no water. They are not able to maintain, and they are buying water around maybe for harvesting methods. All different methods available. They are supposed to give water to others, not purchase. At least they should not purchase. They can sustain, and we cannot, you know. Some institutes are there, they call me about water. If we cannot look for such alternatives. Next. See, that NISA campus only, NISA, National Industrial Security Academy. Huge rainwater, from this it goes to other village. Even that wall twice collapsed. And they have three boreholes in this lane, 1, 2, 3. They can capture as much as possible, and excess water can go out. And these three can wonderfully work and reduce at 40 lakhs rupees per month. And from the other entry exit point is this. The rainwater is going just above that, you know, grills. That much water is coming. And they made a storm water drain so strong, like a bunker. We can travel into that, you know. So not a drop will percolate into the ground. That's how they construct. They allow the water to go out, and they purchase the water. They keep on purchasing the water. They have a lot of space to accommodate other campus water also into there. Not only there. And schools, you know, like I observe how they build. One, some Lions Club or Rotary Club they do, and some old school lies below, and this one comes up, and the water stagnates there. No one maintains proper height like that. See, and the children has to play there around. If you plan there itself during the construction material only, at zero cost we can do the structures. And the water will go down. And the table will increase, and the borewells will have a good life and yield. One last. You can see this. Now all the new buildings in our Hyderabad city, they are not doing rainwater harvesting, but they are giving provision for a tanker. Big tanker will come and stand there. A traffic behind all will be very difficult. And they take Century Hospital. That itself is needing liquid oxygen. It only requires oxygen. See, and the pipes are 24 hours. It is available. When the tanker will come, they will just take the water and the building cannot sustain like that. Now it is like that. Hyderabad in future, how every house will have to have that provision actually. Actually, already having that. See, the tankers. Every apartment, every house, tanker comes, that's all. Traffic has to wait till the tanker unloads the water. Here it's near Durgam Cheru. Some big construction is going on. And next slide. See the tankers, how many tankers are there? Here, one of the tanker, what he is doing, he is taking the water, which is during the construction, which is coming out. That water, he is just taking that, pumping that water and selling it to the nearby corporates or corporate offices only, just nearby, in Orbit Mall. To that, he is selling the water. They don't know, they think that water is a very fresh and coming from a good borehole. And this interesting slide, picture I have taken, water tanker is there, fuel tanker is there. Now, both are competing each other. Okay. Please. Yeah, please. You are asking about the method? The method? Please.
So she's saying if in the city it's all polluted, so the water that's coming in, is there a system to filter it in a way that
like a nature way or something
is not going into the water?
Yeah.
Madam, as I mentioned, like last slide I was telling about NISA, it's like a forest area. It's like a forest. Huge trees are there. Less number of vehicles. Those institutes having 5 acres, 100 acres, 50 acres, campuses, they can do it actually. And one precaution is that the rooftop area has to be clean. No dumping, no scrap should be there. It has to be clean, just clean, that's all. That is one main priority. And second is surface area, no vehicles has to parked. Clear landscape. So that water we'll take, surface water. And we generally aim for the rooftop water. Rooftop water only.
Sorry, what I didn't quite get is just how exactly you're getting the water to the boreholes again. Like,
just from the roof that you set up, or is it other things on the ground itself that you've done as well, like in terms of slope or other things? How do you actually collect all that rainwater?
Yeah, it's one of the small component you are asking. I mean, channelizing.
Yeah, how does that channelizing happen?
This building has a roof, rainwater outlets. They have outlets, 1, 2, 3, 4. They will come down, and we will take from the bottom. And if it is cellar, we'll take from the first floor itself. There will be some problems. So we will channelize that. We will connect all the outlets and gravity is maintained and taken it to the working borehole. That's how we channelize. That's the challenging part actually. Okay. Now presently everything is built, but still we need to carry water.
Right.
And that's the experience counts there.
Right.
Some outlets we have to leave. Some are beyond, we can't feasibly not there. We'll leave it. Maximum we'll take it. Gravity is important.
And then just one other kind of less non-related question to that is just in terms of like the cost of installation. I know it varies per project, but generally, like you could even give just a specific example of, you know, one particular project, how much it costs, and are the costs usually offset in a year or 5 years, or what are people looking at in terms of kind of the economic trade-off there?
As you agreed, cost varies from the site.
Right.
Site decides the design decides the cost. So that is one thing. And some places in 5 years, the expenditure has come out, the entire budget. Some 3 years or some 10 years like that. It varies. Okay. From the number of occupants and the available potential, rainwater potential available.
Okay.
Thank you.
Have you tried subterranean underground water tanks? Have you constructed any tanks like reservoirs? Not just, I mean, this you're channelizing and it's going down to the aquifer, which is very low below.
Yeah.
It could be going 1,000 feet or anything. Have you tried creating tanks, storage tanks? So does that help? You know, percolation tanks, basically, PTs. Does that help?
You are telling the storage tanks?
Yes, like a swimming pool, which is covered.
Okay. Like, you know, CC. Sumps of sumps, stored water, we can.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. Instead of just putting it in the aquifer.
See, situation here, finally, which I suggest is that give it back to the earth. Earth is the biggest tank of the world, and people are not having space. They are not having, you know, sufficient place. They are considered already rooms, and they don't have that space. They can't go for even having a space. Constructing it costs lakhs. That, you know, 1 lakh liter capacity, it also lacks. So most of them are not having space. So if any big builders wants to, and that is a fraction of water it is stored. That can be one of the option in the entire system. You cannot just depend on that, because one rain can fill up your sump, and next rains where you will accommodate? This system only will accommodate.
No, actually, these are percolation tanks. They help to for the water to percolate. Okay, thank you.
We have a 25,000 liter tank under the garage, but you can't retrofit it like he's saying. So these are buildings that he's saying that are already built, and he's making the best use. But if you're thinking of building something, a garage is a good place, because then there's very little evaporation. And then we have a pipe, so when it comes to a certain level, it goes into an open well. Next to the open well is a bore well. So in three different ways, you are arresting the water and, you know, helping it flow from one place to another. So if you're thinking of a new project, that might be a good idea.
Very few people can do like that. Sump that.
So, if there is an open lawn or open parking area, it can be dug up and made into a percolation area.
Again, you know, consists of huge cost, and people have, association members has to agree for that. It's an idea, but in practically, even for a small 50,000 rupees or 1 lakh expenditure also, they will take a long time, 1 year time, you know, it will lie like that only, that idea only it says. But if the aquifer is the real tank, you are taking water from there, give it back. You cannot just empty like that and go for a new borehole. So that's one method we have done already. And we ask for in a questionnaire how many sums are there, unused sums. Why we ask? Because we want to channelize through sump and give it to the borehole. It will fill, they can use it storage, and remaining excess all will keep taking the borehole. Yeah.
Hi sir, could you talk about water harvesting in cities which are in the mountains? Because there, it's a completely different system. We don't use boreholes or any other way. There's generally just the percolation tanks which are used, but it's only new constructions. The old buildings cannot use that. So if you could give a brief about any other method collecting water in cities, in mountains.
In mountains, huh?
Yes, sir.
So which area you are telling? I can, Himachal. But you see, I went to some villages for similar method, giving similar method, because there every farmer is also going with 3-4 boreholes. It's a very common practice. In 2-3 acres, at least you will have 2 minimum boreholes. What I am planning is that at least one borehole, the gravity available, see that the water is channelized into that borehole. And I am preferably looking at the near, just below the mountains. So fresh water will come from there. When I give back to that borehole, the other borehole's life will increase. So this already we are doing at few places, and farmers, 75% of their unfortunate things happened so far. 75% reason is due to boreholes, new boreholes, money on that, getting money on loan for that, crop failure, all that is secondary. But borehole giving up, not at all giving yield after going for 3 boreholes or 4 boreholes, and there are unfortunate things are happening. So that's why the same method I want to use. There's no rooftop there. So only surface I have to take. And the gravity. Luckily one bore is there, having a gravity, we can channelize. The challenging part is that silt is, lot of silt will come. Here only wind dash will come. I can handle very easily. Lot of silt will come. I have to make a different arrangement for that. We are doing that already.
So around Hyderabad, I'm not sure, maybe if, do you know the locations of all these abandoned borewells?
because you said there are thousands in the Hyderabad region. And I'm thinking, even from a perspective of, you know, getting more people involved, it would be very helpful to have something like a map or something of if somehow if we're able to do a survey, maybe we can get other agencies involved in this and find out where exactly all these abandoned borewells are lying, so that then people can look at it in the wholeness of it. Then maybe you can even give out the statistics that, look, we have so many, here are the locations, these are the societies that must do RWH, and therefore we will increase Hyderabad's entire water table by this much meters.
Really,
maybe you could do something like that.
I thank you very much. And this is the need of the hour for me, for our activity. My few friends are working on an app where if I go, half day or one day will be gone. If I go. So app, I am making an app. Once it is done, I will really share with you and friends like you, where they can send me information, borehole picture, rooftop available, all that will come. So that will be maintained, and the people will know this much rainwater is coming on my rooftop, potential, and the life will come up, number of tankers will come down, then the price will be secondary for him when he knows this. So this is what we are stuck actually, and we are soon coming out, and we need help, people like you, definitely. Yeah. Thank you. Actually, madam, I wanted to go for an RTI. I made a draft ready, but I could not. I wanted the entire statistics of this. See, recently, few days back, one small girl fell down in Nalgonda. And 2 months back, one more in Medak, one boy fell down, small boy. And our minister said, immediately identify all those things and close. Also, he said, close out, close. But I sent a mail to that minister, mail ID. Sir, we can convert them into recharge structures. Maybe a few rupees extra may happen, but don't just shut down. Because there are good aquifer recharge points there. We can convert them actually. We can utilize them. Abandon anyway, but convert into whichever feasible. Maybe in thousands, 500 may be feasible. They will be very useful, really very useful. If you go to a village, any village, before you enter, in one way 10 borewells, this way 8 borewells. They have dug, no water, again new one. At least 12 boreholes will welcome you, abandoned boreholes, in every village, wherever you go now. It is the present situation now. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.